Hello, and I bid you a warm welcome. We will now zoom in on the place of interest, which is going to be Italy. And within Italy, you have the main city of Rome, which is right here. And we're going to be situated up here at Cerveteri, just up from Rome. And the place that we're going to visit is the Necropoli della Banditaccia. And this site, first up, with this trip, this happened in 2016 in October. I was with a group of about 9 to 10 to 11 other people. It's fluctuated at times. And we went through various places in Italy, many places. This was the first place on the first day. The group was organized by a lady named Sylvie, who runs the New Earth channel on YouTube. Now, she takes contention with the official history. With this place, it's said to be all tombs, basically. And there is the possibility that it was maybe changed into tombs, but nonetheless, that's the official story. Now, this site is said officially to sort of date back to the Villanovan culture, an Iron Age culture of northern Italy. And it's said to date back to around the 9th century BC. So we're talking around about 3,000 years ago. And then it would also incorporate the Etruscan culture also, said to date back around the 3rd century BC. Now, just going off the information on Wikipedia, they're saying that they estimated that there were perhaps around 25 to 40,000 people, Etruscans, here at this site and around this area around 600 BC. But nonetheless, we can go in and let's have a look at this site. This is the Tyrrhenian Sea through here off the west coast of Italy, just sort of north of Rome, just off the coast at a place called Cerveteri. And this is we'll be having a look at some of the what are described as Etruscan buildings through this area here. Okay, we're actually in one of these entranceways coming down. You can see the damage to the steps coming through this archway here. And we have torch in operation here. The ceiling, volcanic-like.
It's very soft.
Yeah, very soft. You can with the finger there, it actually. So there's this rib going through the center. And as we come down here, it actually finishes up with the circle, interestingly enough.
Right there too, and so on both sides.
Oh yeah, it is too. Okay, so right going up here again. So the pools of water down here, and then just coming up and around, and we've come to this higher level here. This is the top of the dome right here, and another doorway with a bit of a slippery slope going down to another kind of a space down here. In this case, these steps don't seem to be there. So just to get a feel for the extensiveness here with this map, now within here, we've already had a look at some of the little entranceways, and it's just extensive, the building here within the various places. So you can see all these, this plan with the inner rooms, the outer kind of dome constructions, huge. In this mound here, the opening, and coming through the doorway, and then we'll try and get the light to adjust. Many mosquitoes, but you can see there's water in here, but also just having a look at detail of the construction in here. We were just looking in here. Besides from that, we have these bowl-like objects right here also as part of this extensive site. So there are plenty of these doorways heading to the underground edifices. Here we have this model. You can definitely see the model of a house there and a mound configuration, a rather large pillar. Now what we see here are said to be tomb markings, and the more phallic looking parts are said to be markers for the male tombs, whereas the little house there is said to be a marker for the woman's tombs.
With the tomb here, you can see the altar-like aspects, a little bit altar-like, not repeated on this side. Not repeated.
So just to capture the scene along here, there are these various entrances going in and the various protrusions coming out along the wall. Okay, we're just going to have a look into one of these tombs right here. There is mosquitoes all through, and the camera will have to adjust. Okay, oh yeah, okay.
So yeah, my favorite feature in here are these slots.
These slots up in the ceiling. Yeah. How many of them are there? Let's count across. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 slots across the ceiling.
So 14.
So there's 14. With the rib on the center, the rib going through on the center still. Mm-hmm. They're not, these rooms don't appear to be perfectly geometric, do they?
Coltipin said that it was volcanic rock.
Yeah, so carved out, straight carved out of the rock. All right, so also within the floor over here, there is a pit as well. It's quite an extensive pit, isn't it?
They look to be about 4 feet deep.
Yeah.
3 to 4 feet deep.
Yeah.
And then in some of the rooms, there's a second one over on the right.
Another pit here. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And not all.
Look at the markings on the wall, the way it's scraped up.
Oh, yeah.
So just to get a perspective, these scrape marks from the bottom of the wall, and they go right up the wall like that.
Do you think that's from some kind of weathering, or?
It, to me, that looks, I don't know, but it does not look like weathering.
Yeah, it doesn't at all.
They keep going over this direction here, don't they? A shape here. Do you mind put the light right up, open the light up? There's kind of a shape here. The end of the wall, for reference, is here. And reference, this is the doorway out. We'll be having trouble picking some of this up on the camera.
The light's perfect there.
Okay, so we're still in this same room right here, and there is this portal way heading through to the room adjacent to it.
Which is identical.
One aspect I'm going to cover on this trip is just various trickiness within architecture, let's just put it that way. So anyway, within the doorway here going in, and this was the area that we were in, you have the just this way it's carved in the recess of the doorway. It's quite interesting. Whether there's some sort of security aspect to that, I'm not sure. An excavation right there, and then these steps right here, and then this interesting entranceway coming through here. It is a small, very small person would have to get through this. I certainly, this comes up to chest level for me, so I'll try and get a bit more of an idea. It's not completely uniform in here. It's a very interesting, kind of blocked up with rubble at the other end. This probably goes through about 3 meters. Major excavation through here. A stairway leading down in this case. It at the top of it, it actually leads to another staircase. So they both meet at the top right there, leading down. Within the ruins here,
in this case, there is this odd, cart tracks, but in this case, you can see the line coming through here and flowing through and then through this twist right here. And then we have a progression down into this space down here. There's a plaque down there talking about a restoration being done in 1913. But one thing that has been pointed out here is that within this odd curvature, we have these scrapings into the rock again. You can see them through here. So it looks like this is a means of construction. Just looking at the wall, quite a lot of detail. So in this case, looking at the notion of a tomb officially within this mound and the doorway going through. Of course, you see this type of doorway in Egypt. Around this doorway here, I'll try and pick it up on a snapshot. You can see the way that it's constructed. We're now within the tomb here. It's very dark. Okay, we'll have a look through here soon. There is the variant in construction here. You can see it with the rock formation. There is a lion, like a guardian lion, as you'll see around the world in various places here. It's very mottled away, but nonetheless, it's still quite visual there. So we're going to now proceed down this rather large cavity and into the doorway here. Now there are actually the old steps coming down to the sides, but of course the metal steps are here, and then in we go. Press the green button. Now this is quite incredible. So around here, within here, you can see that once again the pillar arrangement with the what appears to be an etheric type release from the top of the pillars. Orbs also, so the orb there also on the pillars. Some of this looks, you got pictures of knives and implements, and then around the bottom of the pillar, a cat, sort of a formation, lion-esque, or so nonetheless also shape-shifted entity in human terms to the back. So a continuation of the Egypt, so with the pillars, again, the Egyptian motif, interesting pedestal here with the orb on it. The entities around the bottom of the pillars, which is interesting, emergence from the pillars. So a really, really, really interesting. Actually, you can see it's still painting. You've still got the original paint in here, how it was done up with the original paint as well. So the floor has this ribbed nature to it right around also. As in all of these rooms, it seems to be sort of a bi-level with the floor, and then in a way it would remind one of the bedding. Now just backing out here a moment, this all looks quite rough finished in there, but we can see here again this scraping on the walls, which is definitely not weathering. Just for a moment here, the whole scene is just beautiful. The backdrop to this place, along with these most interesting structures here in Italy. Now we'll just proceed through this this way around here, looking at the structure of the wall, and proceeding through. Now the doorway here, with the angle of the doorway,
Yes, this doorway has the trapezoidal form. It is slightly slimmer at the top. And indeed, in further instances around the site at Cerveteri, you can see more pronounced versions of this example of a doorway. Indeed, you can see further examples in South America and Egypt also. And on this note, at Cerveteri, there are these outlines of the doors there, and indeed they are a bit of a reminder of what is present in Egypt. Actually, if we look to South America, you may see likeness also. We'll proceed down into here. In this case, within here, there appears to be a pillar. Restoration by the government here, 1928, within this area. This, moving along here, this doorway, interestingly enough, with the archway atop the doorway leading in.
It's as if this is, it's like I can feel myself kicking this in the other foot, right?
Yeah, so possible cart track type setup around here.
Yeah,
possibly, right. Although it's right in the center. Here's another one of these entranceways. Now this one goes through for quite a few meters, maybe 10 meters or so, and out through to the other side. Just within, to add here, the scoop marks on here, I'll try and capture it, but they're quite extensive going right up. So how this was constructed. All right, so looking at the construction here and then going back to this, we're going into the center of this, you have the kind of tracks and the cart tracks around there, or that track, call it what you will. But let's go in here for a moment just to see that there are the three archways leading in around here, and they all lead into the, once again, these rooms with in this case, in this room again, the triptych configuration within here. Okay, so interesting here, the stonework against the wall. The rest of the wall is kind of complete with greater regions of stone, and then this little one here is kind of filled in with stone. Strange. So there is an entranceway into here, and an entranceway either side of it into these further tombs. Let's just go in this one randomly. Okay, slightly different configuration in here with the two holes in the center and little sort of doorways going further into the sides. This place is so extensive and so going into here, just the way the cavity of the ceiling, just to note that, down the three steps into here and then down. Now within here, again, around the doorway, first of all you've got the triptych obviously there, and also the shape of these ones are kind of similar to the doorway, also wider at the bottom, the archway there, and the configuration around the doorway also, which is quite Egyptian-esque. To the sides, these familiar kind of bedding kind of things, and the chairs here still remain in this one, these two sort of seating easy chair configurations. The site is extensive. This is only a portion of it. Within the site of Necropoli della Banditaccia, you do have these cart rut type tracks. A bit of water, I'm feeling a bit thirsty, so I'm looking to have a little bit of a drink. I'm not sure whether to drink from the yellowish portion in here, which is kind of glowing in there, and the greenish portion right here, but very thirsty. It's a very nice day.
Remarkable stonework.
Within this entranceway here, you can see the way the stones are constructed up here, and without going down, but just looking at the hatch marks now, the waves and hatch marks, the markings on the stone, some of it's quite intricate here, you can see the crisscross pattern within the stone. It's extensive. Again, up here, construction.
Starting to get turned on.
There is a mound over here and a mound here, and it's buried, but one of the things is that you can see the construction, the block construction of the mound, of this greater mound. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed the video.